lastly, in sports tonight, the Uganda Cranes leaves this very evening for Rwanda ahead of the Thursday fixture against host the Amavubi Stars in the 2022 FIFA World Cup qualifier. Now, midfielder Khalid Aucho has been named the team's captain, replacing clubless striker Emmanuel Okwi, who was omitted from the team. We have the details.
Aucho insists that the current Uganda Cranes squad will deliver against Rwanda despite a heavy reliance on young players. The young African midfielder believes that the senior players will complement the young ones as Uganda seeks maximum points in Rwanda. Speaking ahead of the game, head coach Uganda Cranes Mitchell said that the team is looking forward to having a good performance against Rwanda, both home and away.
Matches against Rwanda have never been an easy matches. I have been personal witness 7 June 2003 of the biggest match in history of the game of football since 1863, when football became football. 5.5 hours at Nambole, many of us, we have been there. We have seen that it's always tension, small details are decided. Before winning on the field of play, you need to win inside your head. And in men management, partnership management, department management, and overall team management, we want to inject our players with self-confidence, self-belief. Patriotism is already inside them. Quality is already inside them.
Uganda and Rwanda have faced on several occasions, but the most memorable remains in 1998 when Cranes won 5-0 away in Kigali, and the 2004 AFCON qualifier at Nambole that the Amavubi edged 1-0. The team has 2 points from the first two games in Group E, courtesy of draws against Kenya away and Mali home. Meanwhile, Proline Football Club is set to officially launch the Ojukira Legend War campaign this Saturday, 9th October 2021, and a charity football game between Uganda's football legends and the parliamentary football team, consisting of Uganda's legislators.
And the missing link is with the legends. You're all aware our legends are featured in the media time and time, but they all feature in one aspect. Either they have died or they are very sick. From the time when they retire, the next time we see them, or the next time they feature, is because the late Chirunda has died, or Obadiah Semakula is very sick, or Sula Katovu, or Jamiru Kasidie. The stories are endless.
Report compiled by Rachel Temandike for the news.